Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Here is your friend JT Rex. Today I wanted to talk about a excellent console, the Xbox Original or the Xbox Classic. By the time it came out, it was the most powerful console of all. That because it came out a way after the mighty PlayStation 2 and the GameCube. It has such a nice games like Halo 1, Halo 2 and others that only came out in this particular console, like Buffy the Vampire Slayer and a Superman one that is not so bad. On today's video, I'm going to present to you guys a tutorial of how to soft mode or Xbox. So you might be wondering, why soft mode or Xbox? Let's begin with the basics. Soft mode is a term used to describe that a console is allowed to perform tasks outside the scope of the original system. What this means is that you can run copies of your games or just copy your games into the hard drive and run it from there. First of all, we need a USB memory stick, and I think get it today could be quite a challenge, just because these memories are too old and came in very low memory rates. I recommend you guys that click on the link below related to the USB memory sticks, choose one and try to buy it. For this video, I'm going to use a SanDisk 4GB. This one. Another thing that we need is a cable, which is USB to control it port cable. You can get it from Amazon or eBay and it's quite cheap. Also, we need a copy of a Splinter Cell, the first one, okay? Let's get started. Okay, I'm going to connect the USB into the cable, like this. And I'm going to rotate the camera a little for you guys. I'm going to connect this into the second port of the Xbox. And let's see what happens. Okay, from here we choose memory. As you can see, there is a memory on the controller too. We are going to choose this option here. Okay, and let's go to the computer.
Okay, first we need to download this file, which is on the link below and extracted into the desktop. From here, we have to choose a option which is called Build Soft Mode Zip. Okay, as you can see guys, there is a new zip file right here. We are going to extract this. We enter right here and from here to soft mode package. As you can see, these are all the files that we need to do this process. We need to extract two of them. This one with this option, extract here. And this one, which is our save file for our game Splinter Cell, okay? We choose the same option than before and enter right here. We are going to copy these files into our memory stick for do the installation process, okay?
Okay, I'm going to connect the memory to the computer. And I'm going to move the camera for you guys.
As you can see, a message show up. Right here, we have to do click on cancel, because we do not want our memory to be formatted. It's already formatted, okay? Right here, cancel.
Okay, once our memory is connected to the computer, we need to run this application, Explorer 360. From here, we choose Drive, Open, Hard Drive or Mem Card. And as you can see, partition 0 show up. We need to create right here a folder, right click, and choose Add New Folder. Okay, for our import process, we need to choose this folder, and then Edit, Insert Folder. We are going to search for our files, SoftMode Package UData, and we'll pick this one. Okay, we need to repeat the process. Edit, Insert Folder, and we need to search the next file. SoftMode Package UData, and we pick this one. Okay, the last step is to delete this folder. And there you have it. This is the USB pen drive to install our SoftMode into the Xbox. Another thing that I like to recommend to you guys, if you are going to use the extras disk, which I will highly recommend you do, is double click on the option Build XIXO and wait for a few seconds. As you can see here guys, there is a new ISO file which contains all the extras applications. So we need to burn this image into a bland DVD, and we must select a burning speed no more than 2.4x. So I'm going to use this program over here. Then I'm going to select this option, and here I'm going to search my image file, which is right over here. Okay, then we must check two options right here, the DVD ROM here and the write speed, and then we must click in this option.
Okay, once we get all the files transferred into a USB, we are going to connect this cable into the Xbox. I'm going to rotate the camera a little for you guys, and I'm going to plug this into the second port of the Xbox, and I'm going to turn it on. Okay, from here we access the memory option, and here we need to access the memory that is on the controller port 2, which is this one. And as you can see guys, there is two files right here. One is the save file for our game Splinter Cell, and the other is the installer itself, okay, the application. We are going to copy these two files into the hard drive of the console. For do that, we are going to choose the right arrow right here, A, copy, and then A again. Okay, I'm going to repeat the process. Okay, there you have it. Now we can install our SoftMode tool into the Xbox, okay?
Okay, we're going to begin the installation process. So we need to insert the game.
into the console. And wait till we get to the main menu of the game, okay? So here, just wait. Okay, here we are going to choose Start Game and press A. And as you can see, a optional menu shows up. We are going to select that one and press A. And right here, we're going to press A again. As you can see, guys, the LED is showing us a red light. So don't worry, it is a normal process, okay? Here we have the initial screen of our submodel package. Okay, here we're going to press A, and it's going to copy all the files into the Xbox. Just wait. Okay, here it's going to tell us that we need to backup our EEPROM, so here we press A. And it's going to explain more about the EEPROM, so here we press A again. At this point, the Xbox will be restarted. I'm going to press A, and I'm going to take out the disk, okay? So we press A, and we take out the disk. I'm going to finish the installation. Okay, as you can see, at this point we complete the installation process and we have our Xbox submodeled. Okay, another thing that I like to change is the skin, because I like the default one. To do that, first we are going to select System. And then we are going to select the skins. And finally, right over here, we are going to choose the default one and press A. And that's it. This is the new skins that we choose. Another thing that I like to install are the background sounds, which are on the DVD that previously burned. Okay, to do that, we are going to insert that DVD into the console. And right here, we are going to select the option Launch DVD. On this menu, we are going to select the option Dashboard. And down here, we are going to select the option MS Dashboards. Here we need to pick the first one, Stock MS Dash, right over here, and then we are going to install that one. Okay, A here, and it's going to copy all the files into the Xbox, okay? Here for install the sounds, we are going to press A. Okay, A here, and as you can see, the process is completed. We are going to test the sounds, okay? I'm going to extract the disc. And as you can see, guys, all options here has sounds, okay? Okay, by now we complete the tutorial. This is my first video and the way that I have to share with you the things that I love. On the next video, I'm going to show you guys how we burn the games to be able to run it on the Xbox. If you like the video, please click on the like button. If you do not like, it's okay. Thanks for watching and see you guys on the next video.